Enterprise level partnership sends VeChain VET price to new highs. Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Win with Ryan, where we search the crypto headlines, surf the crypto markets, and we surf the world. So today we have a coin that is new to the channel as far as a feature coin. It was in one of my videos several weeks back. It was actually top five coins to watch, and that is VeChain. So we got VeChain news, huge VeChain news actually. And if you were watching my video like almost a month ago now, I believe it was, but it was top five coins to watch for the week, and VeChain was at 5 cents. It actually ended up dipping down to 3.5 cents before coming all the way back up. So I did get into VeChain at 5 cents. It was a very, very good purchase. Went ahead and went strong with it. And I've been very excited about VeChain's performance. And you'll see why today when we go over the actual charts, which we'll do. So what are we going to do today? So today we're going to cover VeChain, the coin, and VeChain is going to be, there is some huge news. So I'm going to cover the news for VeChain. After that, we will then go into the charts and look at the price action for the daily, 4 hour and 1 hour, what it's looking like for the future of VeChain. And then we'll also look at the Coin Telegraph Markets Pro score and see what is going on, and see, we'll just put together the whole ecosystem of VeChain today in this video, and see what is going to be happening in the future. See if we can kind of get an idea of where this is going. So thank you guys so much for joining me today. Let's go ahead and jump right into the article. All right, so in this article by Jordan Finseth, we have enterprise level partnership sends VeChain VET price to new highs. Real world use cases and enterprise level partnerships are just a few factors behind VeChain's recent breakout to a new all-time high. Real world partnerships and integrations into thriving industries are some of the best forms of validation for blockchain projects that are seeking long-term sustainability and widespread adoption. They also have the ability to spark rallies that trigger long-term price appreciation and brand awareness spreads. Since February, enterprise-level adoption and wide array of use cases have worked in favor of VeChain VET, a blockchain-powered supply chain platform that seeks to use distributed governance and Internet of Things, IoT, technology to optimize supply chain management systems. Data from Cointelegraph Markets and TradingView shows that the price of VET has increased more than 400% in the past 2 months, climbing from a low of 0.0263 cents on February 8th to a record high of 13.44 on April 9th. And it is currently trading at 14 cents. And we'll show you that here in just a minute. Major collaborations ignite VeChain price. A scroll through the project's Twitter feed shows that VET's price growth in 2021 has largely been stimulated by the adoption of its supply chain tracking technology. On April 8th, the team announced a collaboration with the software company Salesforce. And here you have a tweet from VeChain Foundation. We are pleased to have worked with Daniel Nordjay, Director of Strategy and Architecture at Salesforce. Daniel has chosen VeChain as the blockchain of choice in a sample enterprise adoption case and successfully connected VeChain toolchain with Salesforce. And if you guys are familiar with typical stocks outside of coins, Salesforce is a major player, huge, huge growth over the last couple of years. And Salesforce, if you talk to any business, they're most likely using Salesforce. Like, as you guys may or may not know, I'm a real estate agent. And a lot of the CRMs that I work with or other brokers work with are attached through Salesforce. That's the actual program that they use. And then they run different CRMs on top of Salesforce. But that is a major, major player in the technology space. VeChain's technology has also been utilized on several projects that are managed by its partner, DNV. DNV uses VeChain's blockchain solution to manage the data from projects with the Danish company Risi and the Norwegian industrial company Hydro. The increase in VET price and adoption since the beginning of February has also led to a 1,000% increase in the price of VThor token, VTHO, which is used to pay for transactions and smart contract integrations on the network. An early March NFT-related collaboration with VIM World also helped bring extra attention to VET and VETHO, as was and was followed by a steady increase in price. The positive benefits of these partnerships were reflected in the data from Cointelegraph Markets Pro, which shows that the market conditions for VET have been favorable for some time. The Vortex score, exclusive to Cointelegraph, is an algorithmic comparison of historic and current market conditions derived from a combination of data points, including market sentiment, trading volume, and recent price movements and Twitter activity. And if you guys are following my channel, I did actually subscribe to the pro membership of Cointelegraph, which gives access to the CoinMarkets Pro scores. And I'm going to show you guys that here. And I've showed that on every video that I do a price analysis with. I try to, if I talk about a coin, I try to show the background of it as well through the Vortex score, because it has helped propel my portfolio to next level as well. So you guys can check that out. As seen in the chart above, the Vortex score for VET turned bullish and reached a high of 73 on April 3rd. So we go back here, April 3rd, which is here, and about 2 days before a similar price spike on April 5th. So now we go to April 5th, boom, the spike there. Following this move, Vortex score increased to a high of 87 and remained in the green zone over the next 3 days as VET price increased 35%. And one thing that I'm noticing with the CoinMarkets Pro score is it turns green and then the price rises a day or two later. It's not just immediately, because obviously it turns green because positive news, volume, things are coming in. So, because there's been a couple of coins where it turns green and I put some coin or put some money into it, waiting for it to rise that day. And it actually happens over the next 2 to 3 days. So just got to be patient, as always, with the market. Now that institutional investors now taking a serious interest in the crypto sector and the ways that blockchain technology can be integrated into various sectors, VeChain's real-world use cases and growing list of enterprise-level partners indicate that there is potential for further upside. So personally, I'm very, very bullish on VeChain. I put a lot of my portfolio into there just recently. In fact, full disclosure, I actually ended up selling out of Cardano yesterday and putting it all into VeChain. Cardano has just been sitting there, and it's pretty exciting because when I made the move yesterday, last night actually, it went up 5% immediately, which was great. And then today it's up 11%. So it's working out pretty well. So very excited about VeChain. So let's go take a look at the charts and see what's going on over there. All right, so here we have the daily chart for VeChain. And as you can see, we have been following this for quite some time. I mean, back on February 22nd is when I actually bought my first bulk of VeChain, and immediately the day that I purchased it, it went down. It went all the way down to 3.5 cents. And I was like, oh no, what did I do? I made a mistake. And then it started climbing back up. Just, you know, obviously it's so funny because when you buy into a coin or a stock, it's like the next day it goes down and you just have to have patience. But anyway, we've been watching it. My goal was for it to reach 10 cents. And as you can see here, we had the target up there at 10 cents. And it did reach the target. And then it actually, when it hit that target, it had a huge pullback. And I was like, shoot, should I have sold at the top? Or, you know, did I make a mistake? Because, you know, when you go from 5 cents to 10 cents, you doubled your money. And then all of a sudden it goes back to 7 cents. You lost 25% of your growth there. You're like, whoa, did I make a mistake? Well, obviously, and I'm not saying this like to toot my own horn or anything, but we held it and it is now significantly higher. And now with all of this extra news coming out, which I wasn't even aware of because I don't follow it on Twitter. I didn't have a huge portion of my portfolio in there until just last night. Now we're going to be following this even closer, but you can see all the different markups that I had going on in the chart. Well, let's go ahead and clear that off so you can see a nice clear chart. And as you can see here on the daily, it has just been in a positive upflow. In fact, if you do the EMA ribbon, which is a really good indicator that I'd like to use, the EMA ribbon turned back on November 23rd of 2020 when the price of the coin was at 1 cent. I mean, gosh, dang it. Could you imagine if gotten in that early? You know, that's like Holochain. So we're hoping Holochain does this. Holochain, I also have a good bit in, super excited about Holochain, but VeChain, as you can see, just been pumping. It's just been riding up on the EMA ribbon. And let's go ahead and take a look at a smaller time frame. We'll go to the 4 hour. All right, so as you can see, when you chop down the 4 hour instead of the daily, there's been short, long, short, long, short, long opportunities all along the way. Just recently, back on March 3rd, is when it did do a long signal, and then it has been riding that long signal ever since. So even if you got in late at March 3rd, it was 4 cents. Then it made its nice run up all the way to almost 15 cents now. So we're really excited about that. Right now, it is in the overbought territory, and it's pretty significant. It's at 80. So, you know, we could expect to see a little bit of a pullback here. You can also see on the candlesticks that they're indecision candlesticks. So we're not sure what's going on. I mean, I could see a move down to the EMA ribbon and a tap, because you'll notice that it always keeps on coming and tapping that. And one thing that you'll know is the EMA, which is the moving average, which is the average that the price moves, is like a magnet for the price. And we've talked about this a lot on the channel. If you're subscribed, you'll know it'll typically come back and tap into it. As you can see here, the bodies literally just tapped that end one, the very first one, which is the 22 moving average. The wicks come all the way down in there and then they ascend back up. But on the 4 hour chart here, we got a doji, and you know, this one is brand new candle, 3 hours and 20 minutes left. So we'll see what this one has. It is definitely still trending up, but it's leveling out right here. And so, you know, this is not financial advice. So I don't know if it's a great time for you to enter now or wait for a little bit of a pullback. But if this is a coin that you're interested in, definitely take a deeper dive into it and look for yourself. Let's go ahead and take a look at the 1 hour. So the 1 hour started its recent long signal April 4th, and it's been riding that one up nice. So it's been tapping, like I said, the 20 on the 1 hour quite frequently. It actually did dip down all the way to the 200. This yellow line is the 200 moving average. And you can see it's doing its thing. So it did come and tap here. It's making its way back up. But what'll happen a lot of times is it'll come back and it'll go right back to this part here, which was the previous high. So what I like to wait for is if this breaks above the previous high, then it could continue its leg of the uptrend. So looking strong on VeChain, very exciting. Let's go take a look at the Vortex score. All right, cool. So this is the Coin Markets Pro. This is the dashboard. I haven't shown anybody this part yet, but if you've used it, you've seen it before. What it does on the front side, it has the Vortex score. It gives you the top three, bottom three, and it lets you see what those coins are. You can also click the top six. These are the top six right now with the highest Vortex scores. And then you can also go up here to the top where it says scanner. And on the scanner, it's just going to give you in order of Vortex score. You can select coin in alphabetical order, price. And if you just click one of these, it'll allow you to see that. So if we wanted to know, okay, who has the highest 24-hour change, we can click that. And it's Saffron Finance, XRP, 26%. XRP is just absolutely crushing. If you haven't seen my previous XRP video, we covered some good information there. Just go back in my channel. You can just hit subscribe, go to my channel and check that out. So, but yeah, so let's go ahead and go over here to the search bar and we're gonna check out VeChain. There you go. All right, so VeChain score is currently a 52. You can see that the positive scores were here just recently back on April 9th. And that led to a nice price increase. And now the price is starting to cool off on the, or the, not the price, but the score of the Vortex score is starting to cool off. But right now, if you look here, this could make a turnaround and start to go up. So let's look on the daily, like for today, what has been going on for today. So starting basically yesterday, and then it turned to April 10th. Once April 10th hit, started dropping down a little bit. So the news that we just read, by the way, came out last night. And so we're down a little bit on the Vortex score. But if you take a look, though, I mean, $9 billion market cap, right? But we're up 7%. Total volume, there's $2 billion worth of flow into the coin today, which is huge. 3K tweets. So I could see this score starting to climb, and that'd be nice. I mean, could we see a continued push, maybe up to, you know, 16, 70, 20 cents for VeChain. That would be really exciting. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video on VeChain. Don't forget to subscribe. We do have that Cinco de Mayo challenge going on. If we have 5,000 subscribers by Cinco de Mayo, we are giving away $100 in Bitcoin or $100 cash, or you can win a Ledger Nano X or a Wavestorm surfboard. It is completely up to you. So thank you very much for watching. Talk to you later.